Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. Shit, I meant gentlemen. In this very video, I'm going to show you how you can boost up your CS 1.6 FPS in other games in general, kind of. First of all, I'm going to start off with Warzone, basically, which is a cracked CS, alright? So yeah, we just go in the game and yeah, I'm going to tell you what you're going to do. Alright, so we're inside CS 1.6 Warzone, cracked edition. I've put my main CFG to the Warzone, basically, which I use on CS 1.6 Steam. So yeah, before that I'm gonna make sure I like enable it. All right, this thing is done for now. So the other step is, by the way, I'm going to leave up that specific CFG on my Discord and make sure you join so in order to get it. Now we're going to start up with basic options of 1.6 in general. So yeah, in here, as you can see, I've not done anything to it. The screen is default, like the resolution, I mean. So yeah, we're going to go up to advanced. So I personally use like turn them down to zero and smoke get, like I use this the worst because I don't personally care. And also the buy menu type, don't use this one, use the old one because it will take like 80% of your screen, man, like trust me. So in here, you, the radar type, you can use solid or transparent if you want, or you can like go on the console and type hide radar, click enter and boom, man. That's how you can like basically do that. So now we're going to go up on video options. Now before I go with the rendering options, I want to tell you something about. So yeah, in cracked version you have like three options instead of one, I believe, which Steam has, like OpenGL. In here you have software and D3D on cracked version. But when I had my potato PC back in the days, I will tell you, it's like specs. The specs were basically 2 GB of RAM. I had an Intel CPU, which basically had like dual core, and hard drive like had like 60 GB of space. Like, bro, that's literally crazy. And the rendering option, which I used to use for 1.6, which was better for terms of FPS, was D3D, man. Like when people like in zombie mode or whenever, like when they used to use like night vision and the flashlight, they drop like FPS, they make your FPS go down. So basically D3D used to handle these two nicely, man, for my potato PC. So I personally suggest you use D3D if you have a weak ass PC, which I used to had back in the day. So now color quality, like I'm not sure if this boosts FPS or not, but I guess I can leave it to you, man. If it does not work to you, just revert back to the highest 32-bit. Now with resolutions, alright, so as you can see, these are the widescreen resolution options. So yeah, for FPS boost, of course you're going to go to normal, like with the display mode, and here it is, resolution. So now I know competitive players use this resolution and this, I believe in CS2 this is used for competitive games, I believe, like face it and stuff. So yeah, you can choose in here which resolution is best for you and gives you best FPS. Like I personally use a customized resolution like 1080x1080 because I don't know, I like it way better, man. So in here you can choose up whatever you want to use, man. Like in mouse like option, like it does not have that specific setting which in Steam CS it does have. So yeah, like this is pretty much it on the game options of cracked CS, I want to say. So now before that, now we're going to go up to the console, of course, and we're going to go with the FPS max to like 10,000, for example. And also make sure the modem is the same amount of the FPS max, or otherwise the FPS, I believe, won't be that stable on CS 1.6 Warzone, I mean, crack. And also make sure you turn developer one on. These are like the three commands which kind of will boost, like will like show your true FPS when you play, of course. So yeah, this is pretty much it on CS 1.6 cracked. Now let's go on Steam because I got more to show up. And now here we go, we're in CS 1.6 Steam version. like Steam has some other type of settings which Warzone does not have. Like in here, it's the same, of course. So yeah, in the mouse section option, as you can see, this was a specific setting I was talking about. Raw mouse input. You make sure you have this enabled, because this will use the mouse's true power. So now let's go on video options. As you can see, oh, it has software. I thought it did not have. So yeah, now this is the Steam like video options. As you can see, Steam has this type of stuff, and basically you might have these two like selected up, or this and this, like everything in here enabled. So you make sure you turn everything off and you keep low video quality on. That's what you have to keep on. So now there is nothing more which you can do like in the basic options in here. So now here comes a console. Now in Steam you have like FPS override option instead of FPS modem, and make sure you turn this to 1. And yeah, and there's another option, I think Warzone has this as well, vsync, gl underscore vsync, and make sure you have this on 0. Basically what this does is, if you have it on 1, this will make your gameplay like your FPS only run with 60 FPS by default back on our Windows slash desktop, I guess. As you can see, these were like CS 1.6 like FPS boost tips, like on CS 1.6 itself, like nothing in Windows in general. So now we're going to get up on these things. So now the first thing you're going to do is search up for msconfig, like basically system configuration. You just open this and you're going to go up to like here, I think it's here, yeah, here you go, like boot advanced options, like make sure you have this enabled, and number of processors, make sure you use all of them like down to the end. For mine, I have like 4 cores on my CPU, and I click OK and I'm like basically done with this part. Now we're going to go up to services and make sure you click like all, hide all Microsoft services, and you can disable any type of services which you basically you don't use in general. Like in startup you can like all like open task manager to this. Also make sure you click this apply and okay. It will tell you to restart, but don't do it yet because we have more and more to go on. So you just click exit without restart. Now in task manager, when you have like when you're here on the startup option, you can disable everything that you don't need. So now this setting of course is for Windows 7 people as well. Adjust the appearance and performance of Windows. You click on this here and make sure you can select for performance if you want, like not if you want, but actually you're going to do this, but I select custom, and these are like the settings that I personally use. So now you're going to go to advanced. You're going to click up in here on change and make sure you have this unchecked, and you select like your main drive, which basically your Windows files are there located. I'm gonna like delete all of this and I'm gonna tell you what are you going to do basically. So now in here you're going to go up to task manager, all right? You're going to go up to performance and you're going to check up for memory. Like in here I have 16 gigabytes of RAM. You might have 8 or 4 or I don't know how much you have, but now you're going to go up to your calculator if you have it on Windows. If you don't have it like me, I would go on Google and like basically type this calculator. So now you're going to like type in here 16, which is the amount of the gigabytes RAM that I have for you. As I said, you might have 8, 4, or 2, I don't know. And you're going to click this with 1024, which is basically 8 gigabyte, I think. So you click this, boom, you get the amount of this, and yeah, you put it right here, boom. This is actually my type of RAM, basically the amount of it, the MB. And now we're going to do this again, but we're going to time it up with 2. Boom. And now we get the amount of the virtual, like the virtual size of it this time. So yeah, you just get all of this done, click set and you click OK. You click OK again, it will ask you to restart, but you're not going to restart it. Okay, right. So the next thing is I've prepared a little, not a little, but a PC tweak pack. Alright, so we're going to get on them. So now, as I said, I've put like my CFG in here and some other stuff. Okay, so now we're going to go up with the first one with a Beast Titus tweaks utility. You make sure you copy this command which I've put in here. So you copy this and you go on the search bar and type PowerShell and make sure you run this as administrator. You do not want to run it without administrator, otherwise it won't work. So now this will pop up here and I click, like, I paste the command and I, yeah, click enter. Now it will take like a little bit until the utility launches up. So now this is the utility tweak, and you're going to go up on tweaks category in here, or option section, I don't know how you call it, and recommended options. Make sure you click this standard and don't click minimal. So now in here you have lots of amazing options, like you can basically take your own risk and selecting all of these if you want, but don't do this. Like you can remove OneDrive if you don't need, remove Microsoft Edge as well, like Microsoft apps, like what the fuck, man, I don't even use this. So yeah, DNS, which basically means like the internet, this will boost up your internet, and make sure you select like Cloudflare in here because that's best internet option ever. Like, yeah, after this you click like run tweaks, and yeah, as you can see in here it will basically show up like everything, like it will create a system restore point. Like you don't even have to worry about this. I've already done this, so I don't need to redo this again. So let's go to the next step. Now I've prepared up some CMD tweaks as well for you, and yeah, make sure you just, like, I don't know, I have them on my desktop already. So yeah, you make sure you like run them as administrator. So first I'm going to go up with a clean cache, of course, that's very important. Like that's what I'm going to start off first. So yeah, it will take like a little bit to get the administrative rights. Here you go. Now in here you can, like, basically what this CMD tool does, it will clear up all your caches, telemetries, like all of the Windows useless stuff. I don't know, I accidentally pasted it. So in here, as you can see, enter your choice from 1 to 10. So now basically you're going to clear up everything. You type 1, boom. When it's done, it says press any key to continue. Like I click enter for, yeah, I just click enter basically. Click 2 again. Like now this is browser cache to clear. If you have any of these specific browsers, you just clear their cache. I will do it for Google. It's already done for me because I've already done this like many times already. Like, make sure you use this tool daily. That's all I can say to you. Now I will do this to Windows Update cache, done. Prefetch files, done. Windows Store cache, done. I will go, yep, whatever was this, Windows log files, useless shit, done. Here you go, memory dump files, done. 8, done. Now I need DirectX shadow cache. I personally don't want to do this because my Fortnite game will be laggy and I don't want to play like a like couple of games, like just to lag, but you do this, man, you do if you don't play Fortnite, like you can do this safe. So now the first part is done, we're going to go up to the DNS server tool. Here you go, this is it. Now this is again another internet tweak setting. So now in here you can set up the DNS to Google DNS, but I would personally set this to Cloudflare DNS, which it works best for me, but you can test out yourself. And make sure you always flush the DNS cache because it's very good. It will clear up the internet junk basically on your Windows. You can always revert back to the default settings if you're not sure as well. Now let me just enable these two so I can have my Cloudflare DNS setting. So we're done with this DNS server change. Now we're going to go up to the keyboard delay DNS CMD, sorry. Now in here, as of course, this is keyboard, like low delay keyboard settings, and I will personally do this one as well, and make sure you do this as well. So next step is, of course, tool CMD. And make sure, I forgot to tell you, make sure you run every single CMD with administrative privileges, because otherwise it won't work. Now in here, you have like couple of services, like Windows services, to be disabled. Like which are useless Windows shit, man. You don't even want. You can always revert back if you're not sure, but I would personally don't want to revert them back, because bro, I don't wanna lag. I'm sorry, man, I'm that guy. Now, before I go to other step, there is something I want to tell you. Just go on the search bar and click services, all right? Searching, yeah, go to services. Now in here you have like couple of stuff, right? You can disable any unnecessary Bluetooth stuff. If you don't use Bluetooth on PC, you can like disable cellular time, like any like services you find useless in here, you can disable them. So now in here you have like some Xbox shit. What does Xbox, like this Xbox services do is like, when you have the Minecraft launcher on your PC, you run it, this will work. Like if you have disabled them, then your Minecraft, like real Minecraft launcher won't work. I personally use Lunar Client Launcher. I think you cracked Minecraft launchers, use T Launcher or other necessary launchers. But yeah, if you don't use like the Minecraft launcher, you're safely safe to disable these for Xbox services. Like, you just double click to them and you click disabled and apply, okay, and you're basically done with that part. Now, this MSI utility is like for, I believe, people who have like GPUs mostly. So yeah, I'm going to run the MSI utility v3. So now this is like for people who have GPUs or not, but see, look, I think this might work out on your Windows. I'm not sure, take your own risk in here. So now for my case, I have like GTX 1050 Ti Nvidia, of course, as you can see in here, MSI. Make sure you have this checked on, and I would personally run this to high, like interrupt priority. I would run this to high. After you're done, you click apply, maybe you click refresh in here, and you're cool with this part. Now there is this thing as well, which I've put, like it's called remove startup apps. I've named this quick, like I already have this, so I don't want to replace it. So let me just run the app. Also, by the way, make sure you run this app with administrative rights by right clicking to the app icon and you click in run as administrative. So now in here you go like on logon. Basically this is like startup shit. Now you can like delete the unnecessary ones if you don't need, but some stuff I cannot delete them. I don't know, it does not allow me. Like in here you can disable any like these are like basically like services mostly. Like you can disable this if you want. You can like disable everything in here, like everything you don't use. If you're not sure, you can keep them on. Like if you disable them and they don't work, you can always turn them back on. And now this is the last thing I want to show you, run apps with high priority. This thing, like I'm gonna show you like on 1.6 things, all right? So like I copy this command, all right? And yeah, I just copy this and done. Now before that, we're going to go up on CS 1.6 basically. Like we're going to open the app and I'm going to tell you everything about this part. Now we're here on the task manager, right? And as we can see, this is the CS 1.6, which is basically opened on the background. And what we want to do is set this to high priority, but we don't want to do this manually, like every single time we open the game. We want this to run automatic, like every time we turn our PC on and directly opening 1.6. So I'm gonna show you the way how you can make this run like automatically. So now we're going to go up on the search bar again, and we're going to search registry editor. Click on this, and of course it's going to ask you for administrative rights, and you click yes. Now in here I've like copied the command of it, and you can find it on a RAR file. You just paste it right here and you click enter, and now it will send you up here. Now as you can see, you're going to click up, like right click this folder, and you're going to click like new. You're going to go up to new, and you're going to click up on key, which basically it will, yeah, another folder comes in here, and you're going to rename this like, yeah, you're going to rename this to the exact name as here. So yeah, you just type in here hl.exe, make sure it's run, like the name is exactly like this here. Boom, you just have done this part. And now you're going to click up on again in here, and you're going to click up on DWORD32, and now you're going to name this to CPU priority class. That's how you're going to do this. Now you can do this for every single application and game as well if you want. I have like done to lots of them, so yeah, I recommend you doing this as well. Now you're going to double click on this, and we're going to change the value data to 3 basically, and make sure you leave the base to this one here, and you click OK, and this part is done. This like registry tweak will take effect when, of course, you have restarted your PC and along like doing all the tweaks as well. Like, I recommend you like do every single tweak in here before restarting your PC, and everything starts to take effect, man. Like, anyway, like, I don't know what more, but these were like some of my own tips that I wanted to show you from other like CS 1.6 tutorials. You will find this PC tweak pack on my Discord server. You make sure you join it so in order you can get it there. Thank you for watching this video. Peace.